Magandang araw mga kababayan, naimbag aldaw yung aming kakailan. Again, this is Sheila, Dr. Hernandez, your licensed immigration advisor based in Timor, New Zealand. So in this video, I will be answering the questions in my last video regarding the work residence long-term skill shortage list. It appears that many of you are confused between work to residence long-term skill shortage versus work to residence accredited employer, and many are asking about the point system, which is skilled migrant category, which is a different pathway. So I will be discussing the key differences and similarities among these three residence pathways. Okay, so this table shows the three different residence pathways. So we have the work to residence. There are actually three types. The first is the long-term skill shortage list, the work to residence accredited employer, and we have the work to residence South Island contribution visa. But that's a one-off opportunity that will end coming May 2018. So I have not included that in this discussion. So and we have the skilled migrant category, which is the SMC. So at first, let's discuss work to residence. Okay. Right, so start with job offer. Is job offer required for work to residence? Yes. So for work to residence LTSSL, you need a job offer in an occupation that is included in the long-term shortage list. And you need to meet the qualification and experience is specified on the list. Okay, so for the WTR accredited employer, you need to have a job offer from an accredited employer. The work to residence category is not a point system based application, so you don't need to achieve any points. Okay, so there's no criteria for that. And then do you need English exam for this work to residence? No, there's no requirement for that. And do you need to meet the salary, New Zealand salary market rate? Yes, similar to essential skills work visa, you need to meet the market rate. Whatever wage or salary that is being paid to New Zealanders or locals must be the same as what you will be offered as a migrant or a foreigner. And then is there a salary threshold that you need to meet aside from the salary market rate? For the LTSSL, no, there's none. And however, for the accredited employer, you need to have a 55,000 New Zealand dollars per year or $26.5 per hour salary. Okay. And then what are the stages involved for the work to residence application? So first stage is to apply for a temporary visa, the WTR, work to residence. And after 2 years in that occupation, you can apply for residence. Okay. Now, how is it different from the skilled migrant category or the SMC? Well, the SMC is a point-based application. Is job offer needed for the SMC? It's not necessary as long as you meet the 160 points minimum requirement to be automatically selected from the EOI. So there are overseas applicants who do not have a job offer, but then they have 160 points, so they can still apply for this residence pathway. Do you need an English test for the SMC? Yes, there are different types of exam accepted by this category. For instance, for IELTS, you need a band score of 6.5 overall. Okay, so do you need to meet the salary market rate? Yes, you need to. So that's the one similarities of all the categories. You need to meet this requirement. And is there a salary threshold? Yes, there is, the $49,000 per year or the 23.5. Okay, so this applies for SMC only. And what are the stages involved? So first is the EOI, and then if you meet the 160 points, you will be automatically selected and you will be invited to apply as the ITA. And then the processing of your residence application. So the standard processing time is 6 months, but this can be completed in weeks or in years. It depends on the completeness of your evidences and the complexity of your application, and dependent on the workload of immigration. So I hope that you have a clear understanding of these residence pathways. Now feel free to contact us for a full eligibility assessment. Our Assessment and consultation costs $150 and can be done via Skype. Thank you.